Welk Show. Now sit back and enjoy tonight's show, especially selected for public television by America's favorite music man, your host, Lawrence Welk.
Hello, folks. A few weeks ago, I had some very special friends here in the village. Three gentlemen who toured with me back in the days of the big band. Yes, Parnell Grinner, who sang with us in the 30s, Cliff Moore, who played the saxophone with us, and Big Morris Knudsen, who drove that great big bus for us. Well, as you can imagine, we had a wonderful, wonderful time talking over those exciting days. Whenever a big band came to town, girls would spend weeks deciding which dress to wear. Boys would save up to buy a ticket and maybe a corsage. It was just like a great big party, and we saluted those wonderful days back in 1980, and opened with a song that was a tremendous hit for one of the greatest big bands of all time, Glenn Miller, with the Chattanooga Choo. A young man with a horn, Johnny Sell, recalling a song made so very popular by another wonderful trumpet man, Harry James. Johnny? Thank you.
that won a gold record for the great Jimmy Dorsey Orchestra.
That's right. And there were two singers featured on that record.
Two
excellent singers. Do you remember?
I do.
Bob Eberly and Helen O'Connell. Let's see what we can do with it. Your green eyes with the soft light, your eyes that promise sweet nights, so deep that in my searching for happiness I feel that they will ever
Every time I hear Guy and Ralna sing, I think how wonderful they would have been back in the days of the big band. They are both the kind of singers every band leader would love to have. Next up are four youngsters who came along a little late for the big band, the Aldridge sisters and the Otwell twins. Here they are to sing a number made famous by Frank Sinatra and the Dorsey Band. Okay, children, let's hear your version.
Thank you.
so much. Larry Clinton had one of the outstanding bands of the late 30s. Let's see how many of you folks remember this famous theme song, the Dipsy Doodle. Gentlemen, one and two.
The boss is having fun tonight, ladies and gentlemen. In the 40s, the fine baritone voice of Vaughn Monroe made him very, very popular with the younger set. Our own very popular baritone, Tom Netherton, recalls one of Vaughn's very famous recordings.
I love you, and there's nothing to hide. It's better than burning. I love you, no use to pretend. There, I've said it again. I've said it, what more can I say? Believe me, there's no other way. I love you, I will to the end. There, I've said it again. I've tried to drum up a phrase that would sum up all that you mean to me. But what good are phrases? The thought that amazes is you love me. It's heavenly. Forgive me for wanting you so, but one thing I want you to know, I've loved you since heaven knows when. There, I've said it again. Forgive me for wanting you so, but one thing I want you to know, I've loved you since heaven knows when. There, I've said it again.
Our musical memory, and Jim Turner. Jim has spent a star attraction at one of our neighboring vacation spots, Knott's Berry Farm, for the past few months. But right now, he sings a song written by the popular band leader, Russ Morgan.
You're nobody till somebody loves you. You're nobody till somebody cares. You may be king, you may possess the world and its gold, but gold won't bring you happiness when you're growing old. The world still is the same, you'll never change it. As sure the stars shine above. You're nobody till somebody loves you. So find yourself somebody. Find yourself somebody. So find yourself somebody to love.
Thank you.
Very, very nice. Folks, if you think today's disco dancing is a little wild, wait till you see Bobby and Elaine doing the jitterbug to Tommy Dorsey's Opus 1.
Bobby Burgess and Elaine Niverson, and that'll take off a few pounds. Xavier Cugat was one of the first and most famous band leaders to feature Latin music in this country. Here's our little Mexican charmer, Anacani, with one of Cugat's great recording hits, Perfidia.
Thank you.
you, ladies and gentlemen, in recalling the big bands, let's not forget the king of swing, Benny Goodman. Here's our own sensational clarinet man, Henry Cuesta, with Benny's team. Let's dance. Yes, Let's Dance was the theme song for Benny Goodman, but it was also the theme song for all of us during the big band years. Everybody in America was dancing, and it was wonderful, wonderful. And now back to our musical memory and the theme song of the late Freddie Martin, Concerto in B-flat minor. Bob Ralston used to play in Freddie's band. And he and Bob Smale would like to dedicate this special arrangement to Freddie for the hours of beautiful music he brought to all of us.
Thank you.
members of the band, that was excellent. Frankie Yankovic, the famous Cleveland accordionist, made this next song very popular. Let's enjoy it now with Myron Floren and lovely Eva Barber. Was one of the all-time great band leaders and a fine composer. Let's enjoy this beautiful Ellington song, Mood Indigo, with our wonderful saxophone man, Skeet Herbert.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're so happy that Lawrence talked Skeets out of retiring and joining Champagne Music. While we're in a Duke Ellington mood, here's another one of his great songs. And we're bringing you Arthur Duncan, dancing to the Duke's Caravan. Thank you.
Jimmy Roberts recalls a hit recording by the late singer and band leader, Eddie Howard, with Neela Vang on guitar.
A rose must remain with the sun and the rain, or its lovely promise won't come true. To each his own, to each his own, and my own is you. What good is the song if the words just don't belong, and a dream must be a dream for two. No good alone, to each his own. For me there's you. If a flame is to grow, there must be a glow. To open each door, there's a key. I need you, I know. I can't let you go. Your touch means so much to me. Two lips must insist on two more to be kissed, or they'll never know what love can do. To each his own, I found my own.
Gentlemen, very nice, Jimmy and Neil, a pleasant musical memory. Some of you folks may remember a German band leader and clarinet man named Mr. Ackerbilk. Let's listen to his recording hit, Petite Fleur, by Henry Cuesta. Thank you. is the fine entertainer, our own Candilo.
As the old maestro himself, Ben Burney, used to say back in the College Inn at the Hotel Sherman in Chicago, yowza, yowza, yowza. It's a lonesome old town when you're not around. I'm lonely as I can be.
Beautiful studio audience we have with us tonight. A fine trombone man, Will Bradley, had an excellent swing band in the early 40s. One of their recordings, Salvage Dogs at Midnight, had a tremendous dance beat. Boys, let's see if we can capture that beat, huh? One and two and... Thank you. Curt Ranty has been with us since 1949. Curt, that's 34 years ago. Can you believe it? Here he is with Kathy Sullivan and the Curt Ranty Quintet with the beautiful song Dream, which was such a hit for Paul Weston and the Pied Pipers. Okay, Curt, the spotlight is all yours. Quintet and some nice saxophone by Russ Klein. Here's a salute to all the Dixieland bands that have recorded the great old standard Panama, and especially the Ray Anthony, who had a sensational recording of this tune. Here we go, gentlemen. One and two. Thank you. Isn't that great? No wonder those big band memories won't go away. They are just too wonderful to forget. I hope you enjoyed remembering the big band days. And now keep a song in your heart and may all your memories be happy.
Good night, until we meet again. Adios, au revoir, I'll be the man.
Stay tuned for musical highlights from upcoming programs of the Lawrence Welk Show.